Joining me now for more on all of this is Austin Nichols. He's a senior research associate at the Income and Benefits Policy Center at the Urban Institute. And Austin, I used to live in Bentonville, Arkansas several years ago. But at the time, Walmart was seen as a rather conservative organization in a rather conservative state. And in fact, the CEO, I think it was 3 years ago, signed a petition supporting a law in the state prohibiting same-sex couples from adopting. So people, I think, are probably looking at this and saying, wow, this is kind of a sea change for this organization. But you don't see it as that much of a surprise.
Well, as I said, I think it's not a surprise in that I think many companies will be making the same choice. And it's, I believe, the VP, Sally Wellborn, I think it was, who said this is a business decision. It's not political. It's not a moral decision. It's a business decision, which they're taking because they don't want to have 51 different benefit policies across the states in which they're operating.
Is it one of these things where it opens the floodgates, you'll see this, or is it going to be a drip, drip, drip type of effect, do you think?
I think the floodgates have already opened. I think a lot of people are moving on this already. And I think more and more companies are making the same decision. As I say, it's a purely business decision. It just makes sense to have a uniform benefits policy. It's not going to cost them that much. I've seen a lot of commentary about it being customers, they don't want to alienate customers who are against same-sex marriage, but they want to attract customers who are for same-sex marriage, about the quality of their workers. But I think it's really just about making the benefits rationalized across the states, not having to tailor their benefits package in each state. But that's not to say that this decision, which is purely for business purposes, doesn't have political and moral consequences. I think it does. I mean, political consequences for sure.
So. Well, let's touch on that just a little bit, because these are, you know, when you think of Walmart, It really got its toehold in the Bible Belt region of this country. Is there a chance that, you know, from a financial standpoint, an economic standpoint, there's a downside for the organization at all?
I'm sure they've looked at that. I don't think there's a huge downside. There is the potential they could lose some customers. I don't think that's going to happen. It could happen. They could also gain customers from people who currently don't want to shop at Walmart and now feel better about shopping at Walmart. But I don't think that's not the dominant thing that's going on here.
You know, I read one analyst who said that this is interesting because some companies are actually scaling back spousal benefits. Mm-hmm. Is there a surprise element in that sense?
Or scaling back benefits altogether, right?
Yes, exactly.
So that's a bit of a surprise, I guess, in that sense. But if you're going to have spousal benefits, I think it makes sense to simply have spousal benefits that are the same across the country. And so that's the thing that makes sense. Whether they cut back on benefits altogether, that's another story altogether.
Now, with the states being different, and you were talking about Fortune 500 companies kind of following suit, what about smaller companies? Because the states are varied in how they approach this. What do you see there with smaller businesses?
Well, I mean, the smaller businesses are definitely they're feeling more of the pinch from the rise in the cost of providing fringe benefits. But I think that they will have less incentive to have the same policy for everyone, I think. And they will feel more pressure to eliminate benefits going forward altogether.
Do you think that this is news, obviously, because it's Walmart, it's a huge corporation, but I mean, do we get to the stage maybe a couple of months from now that stuff like this is happening every day and people don't even pay attention to it? I mean, are we almost at that stage, you think? Or?
Well, it's news because of this connection to the Republican Party and the conservatives, right, which is what makes it newsworthy. If it were another large company that had already expressed support, for example, Starbucks did this well before the Supreme Court decision, right? So, It's news because of the Republican Party, and I think it will expose a rift within the Republican Party. It's the same kind of rift they're going to experience over immigration policy, where there are going to be two large segments in the party that want two very different things.
Well, Austin, we'll have you back to talk about that issue, because that's a whole other ballpark.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thanks very much.